Thank you for joining us today. I'm Rudy Stebbe, and welcome to Episode 4, Windows 8 Tablet Simulator, here on Helpdesk TV. By now you've had a chance to look over our Windows 8 videos featured on the desktop. But how would you like to experience Windows 8 on a tablet? I know, I hear you. You are not one of the lucky conference attendees at Build that were treated to a Samsung tablet to take home with them and preview and develop Windows apps on. Not to worry though, Windows 8 development preview comes bundled with a Windows tablet simulator. And all you have to do to experience this is this. Start the File Explorer. And now click on Drive C, Program Files x86, Common Files, Microsoft Shared, Windows Simulator, and now click on the Microsoft.Windows.Simulator program file. After a few seconds, the virtual tablet will pop up, giving you your very own virtual tablet experience inside of Windows 8. Now first, before we go any further, make sure you have clicked on the hand icon on the sidebar to start the touch simulation. You will now notice that your mouse icon has a plus symbol surrounded by a circle attached to it. This we will now call your finger target. Essentially, anywhere you place this finger target and click the mouse button will simulate a finger press. Following along those lines, if you click the left mouse button on the tablet screen and hold the mouse button down, then swoosh your mouse pointer to the left, and letting go of the mouse button near the end of your swoosh, the tiles will scroll to the left. Doing this procedure in the reverse direction will scroll the tiles to the right. Now, to get to the charm menu, place your finger target on the right side of the tablet screen and click drag to the left. Clicking anywhere on the screen will hide the charm menu. If you'd like to change the tablet screen resolution, just click the little square box on the sidebar. And from the pop-up menu, select the screen resolution of your choice. You can then drag one of the corners of the tablet to resize the window as normal. Just above the tablet resolution button, there are two buttons to rotate the tablet to simulate a portrait orientation. Selecting one or the other button will rotate the tablet either in the clockwise or counterclockwise direction. By clicking on the big Windows logo on the bottom of the tablet, you will simulate pressing the Windows key on the charm menu. Now comes my favorite feature. Selecting the double arrow icon on the sidebar will activate the pinch zoom feature. And you will now notice that your mouse cursor has two finger targets. You simulate a pinch zoom by holding the left mouse button down, while rotating your mouse scroll wheel to either zoom in or zoom out. After finishing zooming the page to your desired magnification, left-clicking and dragging the mouse around will move the zoom window inside your tablet screen. And now lastly, left-clicking and dragging from the left side of the screen will switch between your active apps. I hope you enjoyed today's Help Desk TV. If you have a comment about this program, a question, or a shortcut you'd like to share with me, send us an email message to feedback@helpdesktv.ca. Thanks for watching.